of the challenges laid out in front of you. Can you complete it? We're about to find out. Solo challenge, Madden Ultimate Team time. Let's go. After a rare scoreless first half, these teams now just looking for something as the second half gets underway. Tyreek Hill set to return it. Again, after the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. On the return, it's Tariq Cohen. And bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. The Bears offense now heading back out onto the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one haircut on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down, or no, to have the defense have to hold
it. Trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think the guy's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Yeah, we'll see what his offense can do. On second down, Trubisky. And they'll give it up just short of 45 at the 44. 18 yards the gain for number 18.
And it all came together there. In breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
They go play action here on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. This is Howard on second down. And he'll take it down shy of 45 at the 46. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime means I had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try to chip someone at the second level.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Second and 10, it's Trubisky. It's Martin. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
And Martin, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
It was intercepted. Good job by Johnny. And these guys will take over at the 30-yard line. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after looked like they were starting to drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They're excited about where they are in this game.
There's Beck. Polluting the pressure run. They find some open field here. Oh, slide down to avoid the tackle. Able to find a lot of empty space there. Picking up the first down at a 21-yard gain.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Now a play fake here on first down. Is it a rifle one deep left side? Oh, man, it's caught inside the 10. And finally out of bounds just inside the 10.
Some guys just simply have it. And Randy Moss is one of those guys. His big playability, once again, on display right there.
That's what he's known for. He averaged 15.6 yards per reception during his playing days. Highest career yards per catch average for any punt. It's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Randy Moss, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Rams add on to their lead. A good sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping off with a touchdown to give him a nice two-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
Now, how's going to tackle on the extra point? Hauschka adds the extra point, and it's now 14 to nothing. Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. Let's field it at the 2. That's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Bears offense now getting ready to take over. And this offense last time turned it over when Ford on Ford didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to give a lot of credit to their defensive teammates. They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe get a point again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that loosens up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Again, it's Hammond. Now, he's stripped. He lost the football. And the Rams have got it going the other way. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. We return welcoming you back to Minneapolis. It's the Rams out in front here. They've got control of the football as well as we get set for the fourth quarter. Field it about a yard deep. past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time they were stopped on fourth down, had a drive stalled out. We'll see how they respond this go around.
I'm eager to see what their mindset is, because moving the ball, feeling good, and then that abrupt stop on fourth down. Do they go back to the bench and go, "Oh, we got something else," or do they go to the bench and say, "We blew it ourselves. Let's get back out there and move the ball again"?
And is it different when you get stopped on fourth versus punt? Is that more motivation for the defense or more confidence?
I think as a defense, you're so excited with a fourth down stop. Making a punt, that's your goal anyway. But a fourth down stop, that's almost a sign of disrespect that they went for in the first place. And when you get that, you feel great about yourselves.
Looking deep for Gabriel.
That's a big-time pitch and catch right there. Partner, I remember the days when quarterbacks would try this. They were holding their breath. But nowadays, they're counting on their receiver to be just a little bit better than the defensive back. And it's one-on-one in the ball's in the air like that.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Second and 10, it's Trubisky again. And that's incomplete. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with two straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying, no more. We're taking a stand right here, right now. But it is 3rd and 10. They're going to get after him one more time.
And he's got Miller. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Nice game there, partner. But you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now, they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out. So the right side complete to Miller. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch. But even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
All right, they're hoping to get it to him. He can make a man or two miss, but that one will close the door. That is made complete over the middle. That's Burton. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. And he'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. The Bears on 3rd down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 at this point. This is 3rd and 4. Looking to throw again, Trubisky. First down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. A Chicago first down, the former Jag, Allen Robinson, on a catch from Trubisky. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
2nd and 10 now. It's Trubisky. A screen pass here to Cutler. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It'll be a loss of 1, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11. Here's Trubisky. And that is incomplete.
And that drive is going pretty darn well. 3 previous times converted on 3rd down. But on that one, the defense rose up and said, enough of that.
Get a bit closer.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term. turn here, but it certainly felt like it. And the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope when they have to slog their way downfield. They got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you never
feel right.
Exactly.
They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Despite the late lead, Vince gonna throw. Throw outside, complete to Morris. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. And I'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. Vic and the offense will start first and 10. And he's 4-for-4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. So the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Again, it's Vic. Now that stretch, he lost the football. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
One of those mistakes. That's a fumble, though. When they get to the sidelines, I know you're mad, coach, but they still got this locked down. That's not necessarily true, is it?
Well, their hopes are slim, but you just hate to give them any hope. You could have sealed it right there.
Yeah, I could have finished them off and then taken away all hope, as we like to say.
On first and 10, it's Trubisky. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And it'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19 yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pinch and catch. And with 45 seconds showing, he spikes the football.
Offside, defense.
And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Looking to throw, Trubisky on first down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jair Alexander, and they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
I'm not sure, Brandon, we've seen a sloppier play game this year for a team on offense. Turn it over 4 times and expect to win? No chance whatsoever. And look, I have no idea what the ratio is about turnover 4 times and how that correlates to winning or losing. I guarantee you, it's not very good.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Vic now 6-for-6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. First pick up there, and without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up. From the red zone now, Phil, escaping the pressure right. And he's got it! And he couldn't get there and tackle down at the line. And one of the whistles for a timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. And welcome back, the offensive unit. They took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. They'll throw again. Here's Ben. First out to his left. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. Randy Moss, his second touchdown of the night. And the Rams add on to their lead.
I don't care if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over, because it certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive, but when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You can see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
Hauschka adds the extra point, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns and 21. Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. This field at the 2. And that does it for this one. Pat yourself on the back. You just completed and dominated the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge.